Hi everyone, this video will show you the way I get this drawing, an illustration of a whale with the ancient ship sails at the back. This is the first time I'm doing abstract painting with my watercolor kit. Actually, I'm not really know what to do on the exact steps for this painting work, but I do have these ideas, so without hesitating, let's give it a try. As usual, I begin the process with pencil sketch by using any pencil in Procreate. I do go through Google for whale photos and the watercolor whale paintings, and came up with this whale by my impression from what I went through. For the idea of sail structure, I just refer to the Black Pearl in Pirates of the Caribbean by searching on Google too. So I think I'm enough for the sketch here. Maybe the remaining need to draw is the ropes on the ship. I can plan for it later after color the sails. Now, reduce the sketch layer opacity to just barely see it, and lock to prevent myself from doing anything here afterward. Now add a layer under the sketch, and select the hard edge A, the most common brush you see me pick, and start the coloring for base color. Don't bother to get the perfect shape, and paint beyond the sketch line. Then use this non-permeate mask brush as eraser, to erase the excess part. So this will leave the splotch edge for your subject, and the splotch weight can be adjusted from brush size. I lower the opacity because the color is too thick from what I want. Now I add a layer above the base color and set it to linear burn, to start placing the color value. From now on, I will often add linear burn layers for overlapping colors. This time I used an ink brush as an eraser. Develop a habit, always add layer for your next move whenever you are satisfied with your current one. Thank you. I merge up those layers with linear burn blend mode? I think want some part of the whale belly stay completely white as brightness, so I add a layer between the value and the base layers, and paint with white color. If you find that the effect has been different after you merge the different blend layers, then you'll have to undo them and keep them in separate layers. That is why you see me usually only merge the layers with the same blend mode. The next step is to add some fine lines and details. Consider that as another element in the painting. I will keep it in the separate layer, so if I want to make any changes or edit, it will be easier. feel that the work for the subject is enough now. Before we go for background, I will do some sorting for the layers. Usually I merge by base color, value, detail or line and white light. Now add a layer to the bottom. For the cloud I use the smoky spread brush. It will gen some soft cotton-like shape, and pull with smoky fade effect, right purposely made for background use. I don't want to color all the way from light to dark, so I duplicate one copy to double the color value. Again, add layer in order to prevent the failure dragging down the previous works. I'm not done with the background yet, but now I'm gonna do some touch out. And also add a layer between the subject and background. This is considered a masking use. Add a layer for placing the light of the clouds. I use the ink brush Ding Si Show to create the edge light of the clouds. Now the second step for the edge light, use the blender brush, and blend the inner side of the edge light. And try to keep the outer side stay sharp, maybe a tiny little for outer, like presenting the clouds as dissipating. So overall you are getting the cloud like reflecting the bright light. Now I try to redress some light-colored places. Next, I will add some darker cloud shadow. To do this, I add another layer under the cloud light. so I can boldly try without affecting the previous results. Now I will try whether I can have various colors for the clouds. Duplicate a copy of this layer. And then go for hue, saturation, and brightness adjustment. And now randomly erase some place, so that there can get back through the previous color. Now apply the paper texture. This time I pick the texture called cotton rough. Have your brush size to maximum, and spread and cover the whole canvas. This kind of paper pattern is quite common in real watercolor paper. Now duplicate one copy and set to overlay. And duplicate one more and set to color burn. And adjust the opacity to my desire. I duplicate one more layer with an overlay to double the contrast value. I'm almost treating it as done. There are some details left to correct. Hope you learned something here, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in next video.